It's Fred.
Nah, I'm gonna die. Nah.
The YouTube phenomenon, starring in his first movie.
I'm so excited.
Fred the movie.
Hello, both of you. So your first featured role. What's it? What's the experience been like?
It was really fun. I think because it's such a, it's like such a fun film and it's crazy and there's lots of energy. So it was really fun to be a part of Fred. Definitely.
Lucas.
Yeah. It's been crazy, yeah. I mean, it's my first ever movie, and I have like so many lines in like every scene, so it was really like kind of scary at first. But luckily, like the whole crew and cast and everything, like we all got along really well, and it went really smoothly, and it was just a blast.
When the girl next door,
that's Judy.
She's my girlfriend.
Boys, quit staring.
Moves away.
She's gone. Somebody call 911.
You're both a testament to the power of the internet. And success from that. Is it something that you would recommend other artists to go for that are trying to push themselves forward?
Yeah, definitely. I think things like MySpace and YouTube and Facebook and all these like network social networking sites are great because, you know, like when I first started posting my music on MySpace and on YouTube, people in like Japan and like crazy countries that I'd never been to before could hear my music and see it online. So it's crazy, like the power of it and how many people it can reach out to. And obviously, like, to be able to, like, and Lucas making videos on YouTube and now he's got his own film, so it's quite crazy.
Yeah, it's crazy with YouTube and everything. I think, like, anyone, like, no matter what your age is, you can, if you have an idea, you can pretty much, like, show it to the whole world, which is, like, really exciting.
Fred's biggest adventure ever begins.
Here I come, Judy!
Ow! Pixie, you've got a background in acting anyway, but what was it like performing comedy?
It was good fun. I think it was definitely a great film to have as my, like, start as my first film because it was so much fun. And the scenes and the script are so, like, clever and really, really funny and... Yeah, it was really fun.
And for you, Lucas, what was it like, your executive producer, to have a British Judy?
I think it was really cool. Like, I mean, I think, like, Judy needs, like, something that makes her, like, really different from everyone else in school because she's, like, the most popular person. So I think, like, if, like, a British person came to the U.S., like, that would be, like, they'd be, like, really popular because of their accent.
Really?
Yeah, their accents are awesome. Everyone in America wants one.
They do, actually, yeah.
I gotta get the Judy's out! Oh, my damn it, we're here!
That's good. That's real good.
And what's it been like filming a film compared to shooting pop videos?
It is really different, I think, because obviously music videos are, you know, like 3 minutes or something, and... it's like a quick storyline, or sometimes it's just shots and like you get into the character of the song and you mainly just do kind of takes of the whole song and like dance routines or whatever. But with films, it's kind of like the scenes, you start and stop, and you do it again, you get back into your character and you run through the scene again, and you have like microphones like this in your face and like cameras and it's all really exciting, but it's just they're really different, but I enjoy doing them both.
And Lucas, what was it like for you as you're getting older now, connecting to Fred, who's still a six-year-old?
I think in the movie we kind of looked at Fred like in a different way because he's like he is a six-year-old, but like I think it's just like he's in the mentality of a six-year-old, but he's actually like 15. So I think it was, I don't know, just since I created the character, it wasn't very hard like getting into the character because I know like pretty much everything about him. So
starring Jeanette McCurdy from iCarly.
You want to try something cool?
Pretty fun, isn't it?
It's really fun. But what if I have to go to the bathroom?
Pixie Lott in her first starring role.
I brought you a gift, Judy.
A squirrel. I love squirrels.
Fred's voice is very unique, shall we say. But can you tell us more about the process? Because that it is your voice, but it's not all that, is it?
Well, for the YouTube videos, I talk like I do in the movie, but I like give it a little something with the editing. But for the movie, it actually is just like, I think it's just me, and I don't think they did anything to it because they didn't want it to sound like too, like...
ear-piercing.
Yeah.
Did you have to be careful? Because there's a lot of screaming. Do you have to do anything to look after your voice?
Yeah, like definitely towards the end of the filming, like I was like felt like I might lose my voice because like there was so much screaming and all that. But luckily, like they had like a lot of tea on the set and stuff like that that helps your throat.
WWE superstar John Cena.
She's been kidnapped.
Judy.
By kidnappers. Yeah, my house.
and Lucas Cruikshank as Fred.
And what was it like being directed? Nobody knows the character as much as you do. Do you take direction well?
Yeah, definitely. I mean, I think, like, for the movie, I got, like, me and my managers and agents and everything, we got, like, a team together that really understood Fred and understood, like, what I thought about Fred and the movie and everything. So I think they really understood it, and Clay directed, and he was, like, an awesome director.
Yeah,
and
really fun.
Yeah, so we definitely took direction good.
Sometimes I just don't like showing my body too much because, you know, too much sex appeal.
That was awesome.
Make a date with Fred the Movie.
Ow, that was awesome.
Only in cinemas this December.
End of the line.
You're gonna kill us.
No, it means you gotta get off.
Oh.